Hello, this is Mr. Kolopa. I'm here for the next lesson. Let's hope you're going to enjoy the next lesson that we're going to have. It will be under factorization. So, under factorization, we have four subtopics. The first one is how to find the common factor. The second one is factorized by grouping. The third one is factorized by difference of two squares. Then the last one is factorized by quadratic. So the first lesson will be under common factor factorization. So what is to factorize? So if you remember very well, the previous lesson that we had, I don't know if it was the third lesson, we looked at how to expand. If they ask, can you expand this one? You are supposed to multiply these two by x and these two by 3. So 2 by x will get 2x, 2 by 3 will get 6. So now to factorize is just to go back to what we had. This one will become now a question. Then the answer will be this one. How do we factorize? To factorize, just to bring back the brackets that was out when we are expanding. So how do we factorize? We need to find the common thing which can go in this and in this without leaving a remainder. So in this case, the 2 can go into 2 and 2 can go into 6. So we can say 2 brackets. If you say 2 into x, 2 into 2, you get 1, so which will be 1x. We are just going to write x. Then 2 into 6, we'll get 3. So it means we have factorized. So this number which is outside is what we are calling the common factor. So when I say, let's find the common factor, I'm simply asking you to find the number or a letter that can go in what you are given, in two terms that you are given. So in this case, we only have two that can go into 2x and 6 without leaving a remainder. And that is what we are calling the common what? The common factor. So as usual, let's try to write some notes. The lesson for today, we are talking about factorization, and the first subtopic is the common factor. We should know how to find the common factor, and we should also know, when you are talking about the common factor, what really are we talking about? So in this case, we are saying to factorize is to bring back the brackets. Those who have followed me, we talked about 2x minus 1. That is an expansion, not so. This we multiply that, we get 2x minus 2. So us going back to bring back the brackets, we'll be given this like we have given. So we need now to bring back as we are factorizing. So simply to factorize, to bring back the brackets. I don't want to bring things that are complicated to you. So it's very easy for you to understand it when we just say to factorize, to bring back the what? The brackets. So let's look at this one. We want to factorize. So if you look at this, how many terms do we have? We have this term and this term. So we need to find what we call the common factor. So this common factor, what is common in this case? Do we have a number which is common from this one and this one? No. We don't have the number that, in this case, we have a 1. And we don't consider 1 as a common factor. So we only have a letter. If you look at here, we have xy, we also have y. So y in this case, it is common. So this y, which is common, is what we are calling the common factor. So that common factor is supposed to be factored out the brackets. So in this case, I'm going to write the y, which is common. Then once I write what is common, then I bring back the what? I bring back the brackets So what am I going to remain with there? If you take out y in this case, you remain with x minus. There, if you bring back, this is common. The y will come out, it is common. So this y and this y, it's the one which makes this one, which is outside. So in that case, we remain with what? We remain with y. We remain with 3. So you can only prove, you can also prove this. If you can multiply y times x, you get back to x1. Y times 3, you still get back to what? To 3y. So it means you have factorized. Very simple, the common factor factorization. Let's quickly look at question B. So when you see x squared, remember we said x times x is equal to x squared. So if you have x squared, it means you have two x's. So in this case, we have 2x, which is the same as xx. So there we have xy. So it's like we have xx plus 4xy. So you can see that we have x and x, which is common, which we are calling the common factor. So that x, which is common, we write it outside. You open the brackets, we remain with 1x, then plus. There, if you remove that, you remain with 4y. So I'm going to go forward, 4y. So that means we have also factorized. We can also prove by saying x times x, you get back to x squared. X times 4y, you get back to 4xy. Let's quickly look at question C. So if you look at question C, you want to factorize. You can see a number and a number there. Then you need to ask yourself to say, which number can go into 4 and 6 without leaving a remainder? So in that case, we can take a 2. 2 can go there 2 times. 2 can also go into 6 3 times. So the 2 is common. Do we also have a number which is common? Yes, we have said x squared, it means we have 2 x's. So 1 x and that x, it is common. So I'm going to write x as well. Then you open what? The brackets. Remember, we are factorizing, we are bringing back the what? The brackets. So you now divide 2 into 4, you remain with 2. Then we add 2 x's. So you take one outside, the other one will be what? Will be inside. Then minus 2 into that, you get what? 3. 2 into 6, you get 3. Then the x, 1 x there and this x next to the x which is outside. So that means we have factorized. You can also prove by multiplying 4x, here 2x times 2x, you get 4x squared. 2x times negative 3, you get negative 6x. Very simple. So let's try this one. So as you are watching, can you try to pause the video and try to answer this one and see what you are going to get if that is what we are going to answer. So can you quickly pause the video, then try to answer this one on your own. Okay, yeah. So let's now do it so that you can prove your answer. So in this case, we have 2 x's and 1y. There we have x and y. So 1 x there and this x, common. Then this y and the other y, common as well. Open brackets. So you have 2 x's, one will remain, the y will be outside. So that means you only remain with the x there. Minus xy into xy, it's 1. So xy into xy, the answer is 1. So what does that mean? Anything into the same thing, you get a 1. Each into, much into is equal to 1. If you say 2x plus 4, x squared, you try to factorize this one, you find that 2 can go into 2 and 4 without leaving a remainder. So 2 will be common. Then x also and 1x there is also common. You open bracket. So you can see this 2x and 2x, you divide. If you divide 2x into 2x, then you get 1. So anything into anything, the answer is what? 1. You into you yourself, the answer is what? Is 1. So that marked the end of our lesson for today. Let's hope you are following our lessons. Let's hope you have a book. You are copying what we are giving you. We are going to give you the series of topics from the simple topic which is in grade 10 up to the topic that is in grade 12, which we can say maybe transformation. So we are going to give you all the topics and we are going to revise all the past papers that we have written so far, especially the new syllabus from 2016 up to 2021. See you next time as we are having the next lesson, which will be under factorization by grouping. See you next time. Thank you.